this is your partial bed bath skill. I'm going to start by sanitizing my hands. Hi, Elena. My name is Jeanette. I'll be your nurse's aide today, and I'm here to help you with your bath. Give me a minute to get my things. I'll be right back. I'll go ahead and pull her privacy curtain. For this skill, I am going to need a basin of comfortably warm water. I always suggest that you get about half to three quarters of the way full. You don't want it too full where you're going to spill it transporting it, but you also want to be sure that it's going to stay warm. If you only get an inch of water, it's not going to be warm by the time you go to wash your person. I'm going to need a clean gown, a bath blanket, soap, and my gloves. We're going to go ahead and put her up to a good working height, about mid-thigh to waist level on me. Thing to show you guys. If you ever get a glove that looks like that, see how it's real worn and it's not even the same color, you can see my skin through it. Get rid of that glove and get yourself another one. First, I'm going to unfold my bath blanket halfway, and we'll cover your top half up there, and then we'll pull her sheet blanket down. Yes, if you could hold on to that for me, that would be perfect. Thank you so much. Gotta love those cooperative residents. Okay, so next we're going to remove the dirty gown. Remember, I tend to see people forget this step when they're testing. Don't forget that if you're giving someone a bath, if you were getting a bath, you'd want to put on clean clothes, right? So do your residents. So we're going to keep her covered and remove this gown. Now, it specifically says on the list of supplies that the testing centers are supposed to have, that the gowns will not have snaps on the arms. So don't think you're just going to be able to unsnap the arms. Put that into our dirty linens. Perfect. You can set that down now. You're so cooperative. To uncover her arm just for a moment and take a towel and put underneath. Okay, could you lift your arm? Thank you so much. Cover you back up because I don't want you getting cold. Now we're ready to wash. Three washcloths. First one, no soap. You're going to wash their face, and you need to make sure that you are washing their eyes with a different spot on the washcloth for each eye. It's always good nursing practice to wash inner to outer. So we'll wash inner to outer. We'll flip it over, inner to outer on the other eye. And it's also good nursing practice to start on the eye that is furthest away from you first. So first we're going to wipe her eye. I'm going to flip it over so I have the clean side. Wipe the other eye, and now we'll just wash her face. And that can go into our dirty linens, and we'll pat her face dry. that can go into our dirty linens as well.
Now we'll go ahead and expose that arm again.
So we're going to be washing her hand, arm, and armpit. The cleanest part, makes sense, would be the arm, right? So we will start with the arm. And quite frankly, nobody wants you washing their hand after you want to wash their armpit. So we will go arm, then hand, and then her armpit finally. So I've got my second washcloth. We're going to add soap to it.
Scrubbed up here. Get your arm real good. Get your hand, making sure I'm getting in between those fingers. And then up in your armpit. We're going to rinse the same way. And now we'll powder dry. And I'm going to remove this towel right now because I have a bad habit of forgetting that towel. It'll all go in my dirty linens. And we'll give a new gown on. And get her covered back up there. This will go into our dirty linens as well. Put our bed back down. Is there anything else that you need, Alina? Okay, there's your call light. I'm going to open my privacy curtain. Not spill things, so I'm going to put soap away. Soap went into the supply cabinet. Now we'll go dump our basin. Dry our basin out. This will go back into our supply cabinet. I'm going to remove my gloves. Finally, I will sanitize my hands one more time.